Hey there, welcome to our channel where we teach you everything about fashion and design. Do you want to learn how to make professional garments like a pro? Do you know what is the first thing you need to start your production process? If not, then you are in the right place. But before we dive into the topic, let me introduce myself. My name is Muskan and I am your guide. So, what are we going to learn today? Well, let me tell you the secret behind every successful garment, the technical package. You might be wondering what this is and how it's made. Don't worry, I am here to explain everything to you, pal. A technical package, or a tech pack for short, is basically a detailed blueprint of the item you or we are going to create. It contains all the information of our final and approved design, such as measurement, materials, colors, etc. With the help of this, you can create the same design or product without any hassle. All you have to do is to follow it. Sounds easy, right? A tech pack can be of anything, but today we are going to focus on how to make one for our garment. Here are some samples of different tech packs that you can check out. Now, let's see how we can make our tech pack using CLO3D. I have this pattern here and we will include some parts or measurements of this in our tech pack. To do this, we need to use a tool called point tool measure. This tool works like an internal polygon tool, but with a twist. You can jump from one pattern to another, which will measure your pattern automatically. How cool is that? Let's try it out. We are going to measure the front chest part of our garment. Keep clicking the left mouse button and measure in a straight line. To end this line, instead of pressing enter, double click in the end instead. After that, you will see a yellow line, which means our measurement is noted. Easy peasy, right? Let's do the same for the round waist of this pattern too. Keep selecting in parts and we are done. Now, where can we see these measurements? Well, if you look at our right side, instead of fabric, we have a new window open, that is POM. This is where all our measurements are recorded. Isn't it handy? In the 2D window next to POM tool, we have another tool to edit our measurements like most of other tools have. This tool will help you to select your old measurement and you can also see that the connected measurement is selected in the POM window too. Here, you can rename your measurement, because if all the measurements have the same name, then how will we know which one is which? Let me rename them and take the rest of the measurement. We have taken lots of measurement, but if you need more, you can always add more. After finishing all this, our next step is to save these measurements as an Excel file. To do this, you have to select this side option and save it to your desired place with a desired name. Let me open this file for you to see how it looks like. This is how your measurements will appear in an Excel sheet. Later, you can modify them as you like, either by changing them or by copying these measurements to your default tech pack sheet. I have created a professional looking tech pack for you all using these measurements and some other information and details. You can create even better tech pack by adding more features and specification to your design. By using this tool, you can create tech pack of different product with ease. I hope this video helped you to understand how to create a tech pack using CLO3D. If you have any question or suggestion, please leave them in comment box below. I would love to hear from you and answer your queries. And don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel for more amazing videos on CLO3D and other software too. Thank you for watching and see you next time. Bye.